Hello, my name is Dejan Bojkov, Grandmaster from Bulgaria, and today we're going to speak about the good and the bad couples in chess. One of the most famous good couples in chess is a rook and a bishop versus a rook and a knight. The explanation for that is that, okay, usually the bishop is the stronger piece of the knight, and in most of the cases the endgames with the bishop versus a knight are favorable for those who have the bishop. If you had the time to look at this chess mentor course that I made for Chess.com, you will know why. And the other thing is that these pieces both are long-ranged and they can support each other, they can cooperate in a good way, and they can easily switch from one flank to another. Therefore, they are very effective. And the first sample that I would like to show you is a game between Frank Marshall playing his white against the world champion by that time, Emmanuel Lasker. This is the position. They have just gone into an endgame. It is black to move. It's quite complicated endgame, actually. Both of the parties have their weaknesses. White has a weakness on e4. And also his pieces are not very well developed. On the other side, we can immediately see that he has a very nice plan to place his king on d3 to attack the weak pawn on d4. Also black's pawns are not very good for the time being. And if he manages to achieve the setup king to d3 and then the knight via d2 to b3, attacking the pawn on d4 and probably the one on c5, he will have significant progress and probably he will be even better. So black needs to hurry to prevent this plan, and for him the essential thing now is to activate his pieces, his major forces, the rook that costs 5 pawns, we already know that, and the bishop, they have to be activated to the maximum. So the first move, rook b8, is perfectly understandable. The rook is taking the open file, attacking the pawn on b2. White has to lose some time. And then the second move, rook b5, is not that obvious, but it is perfectly sound. The rook is getting on the fifth rank, ready to attack many of the white pawns. The concrete threats are rook c5. Rook e5 can also be a threat. For example, in the line, let's say if white plays c3, rook e5 is already winning a pawn. Also, if white wants to develop the knight via a3, then rook e5 attacking the pawn is forcing rook e1, and then rook a5 is winning the pawn on a2. So already white has a difficult choice in the game. He chose the move c4.
We hope you enjoyed this video demo from chess.com. Subscribe today to finish this video and get unlimited access to our full video library. Your membership also includes access to Chess Mentor, the most advanced interactive training tool available anywhere. You'll also get full access to the Opening Explorer, Tactics Trainer, and much, much more. So sign up today and get serious about improving your game.